Hey everyone, welcome back to The Life of Emily. My name is Emily Cirillo and I'm so happy you're here because today I'm going to be using my August Boxycharm as well as my August Ipsy bag, and we're going to create this look, and I'm going to show you how I ended up like this. Before we start, I want to remind you, please remember to subscribe to my channel down below. I put out 3 new videos a week, so you don't want to miss them. Make sure to hit that notification bell so you can keep up with me and Bentley, as we are very busy people. No, I'm just kidding. We're actually really boring. But anyway, subscribe. Okay, I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see how I got this look, then keep on watching. But here with me, I have my August Ipsy bag and my August Boxycharm. This is my first month with Boxycharm. So what I'm going to do is I have certain things in here that I want to try and incorporate into my makeup routine. And then what we're going to do is I'll just supplement the routine with stuff that is missing just of my everyday collection. So that way we can just keep it moving and we can see how these products work with my everyday collection. I do not have a primer in my Boxycharm or Ipsy for this month, so I'm going to be doing the Makeup Forever mattifying base. I got this from my friend Amber. We did like a makeup trade. So what I'm going to do is put this on the areas where I get the sweatiest. After I let that primer sit for a minute and it's dried down on my face, I'm going to be using the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. This is in shade 363C Nude Ivory. I've been liking this okay. It's been really hot the past few days and it's gotten kind of sticky. So I'm going to try it today with this matte primer to see if it performs any better. So I'm going to go ahead and put this all over my face. I'm going to blend this out with my Dampen Beauty Sponge. This is a Morphe sponge. So I decided, because the next two steps are also just for my everyday collection, I'm going to go ahead and do those and speed it up so that way we can get into the new products. So as usual, if you're wondering, this is the NYX HD Concealer and this is the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder. The next thing I'm going to be using is out of my Ipsy bag. This is a Pixi by Petra. This is a fresh face blush in Beach Rose. And I'm just going to be using my KKW Beauty contour brush to apply this. So I like this blush, but it's a little bit dark for me. I could almost wear it as a bronzer. But it's still kind of warm, so I don't really love the color, but I think it's a good product. It's very pigmented and it blended very beautifully on the skin. The next thing I'm going to do is contour my face with my Everyday Contour Palette. This is the KKW Beauty Palette. Okay, so now that I'm bronzed up, I'm so excited to be starting the eyes. I've been really excited for this Laura Lee Los Angeles palette. This is the Party Animal. And I swatched these last night, but I think that this palette is absolutely beautiful. And since she announced it on her channel, I've been like, girl, where can I get that? We're gonna go ahead and jump right into the eyes. Whenever you're doing a look with a really, really colorful palette, and you're worried about fallout, which I'm always worried about fallout, I'm probably gonna have a meltdown today because I did my base first. This is what you can do to kind of avoid it. So you can just take a beauty sponge or whatever, put some loose powder on it, and just stamp it wherever you're gonna be doing your makeup and where you're afraid that there's gonna be a lot of fallout. And I'm gonna kind of soften that out on that edge so it doesn't completely ruin the blush. So it's just kind of like, I look so crazy. I just gotta look at myself. Girl. So I have my Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray on deck because I'm definitely gonna use it, because these shadows are gonna be more pigmented if you wet them. So the first color I'm gonna start with is this one right here, Damage Control. And I'm just gonna get this all over my brush. And then I'm gonna wet it. Little setting spray, and then what I'm gonna do is stamp it on the outer corner.
Okay,
I'm doing is just stamping it right on, and I'm blending it a little, but I'm being really careful to make only tiny movements so we don't make a mess if I do blend it. Otherwise, we just stamp it right on there. So I'm going to be using this brush as we go to swipe away any fallout. So the next thing we're going to do is take this color right here, bottoms up, and we're going to get it all over this brush. This is very powdery. Like, it's really pretty, but it's very powdery. So we're going to spray it, and then we're going to pack it on in the middle of our lid. I changed my mind. We're going to be using this brush now. This is just one of my flatter brushes. And I'm just going to pack on this pink until I like it. And what I'm doing now is, after I have the pink where I want it, I'm just blending that edge a little bit and laying down a little bit more blue, putting it right up against the pink. I think it looks so beautiful. It looks like there's like a little line of purple where the colors have mixed. Love it. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is I'm going to take this color right here, and what I'm going to do is put it on the right, on the inner corner of my eye, and we're going to put some of this glitter glue down first. So this is a flat, little, tiny concealer brush. This is what it looks like. And I'm just taking that glitter glue and patch it and just packing it onto my eyelid, because I don't really know how to use it. So I'm going to use a thin layer of it, because that usually works when you don't know how to use makeup. Let it sit for a minute, kind of like you do eyelash glue. Okay, now we're going to go in with this one. I'm going to take some more of this and put some setting spray on it and just continue to pack it on my eyelid until it looks exactly how I want it. And dust away that yellow fallout. So this is what we have so far. Now what I'm doing is just carrying this down to under my lower lash line. Now what I'm going to do is take this purple right here called Hungover. I'm going to take it on, this is a pencil brush, but it's pretty big. So I'm going to take it on the whole brush, like the whole tip of the brush, and I'm going to put some setting spray on it. And now what I'm going to do is put Hungover under my lash line. So I'm going to concentrate it pretty heavily right up under my lower lash line, but then it's okay if it falls down. You can drag it down a little bit, but what I'm going to do is make sure the darkest part is right up at my lash line. Now what I'm going to do is take this color again, same thing, and I'm just going to bring it out under this blue, because I think it's gonna look so cool. I mean, like, who knows, but I think it will. Now what I'm gonna do is trace the outline of these colors with that purple. Now what I'm going to do is take this Morphe Y21. It's just a flat brush. And I'm going to do the same thing. But I'm just going to trace out that yellow on the inner corner. And I'm also just going to go ahead and like blend out the edge of this so that way it's not so harsh. Okay, so now that we're done with this side, I'm going to go ahead and do the other eye off camera, and I will meet you guys right back here as soon as I'm done. Alrighty, I am back. I just finished the other eye using this palette because we're ready to move on. But unfortunately, the next product is not a new one either. This is just my eyeliner. So I'm going to go ahead and do some wing liner. Maybe, I don't know what I'm going to do yet, but I'm going to think about it and I'll be right back. The next thing I'm going to do is lashes. This came in my Boxycharm. These are the House of Lashes Noir Fairy Mini. So I have some lash glue out here. I'm going to go ahead and put it on my hand. And if you do not know how to do false lashes, I did a tutorial on my channel. I'll link it below so that way you guys can watch it if you want to learn how I do my false lashes. This lash band is really thick, so I'm glad I went ahead and put some liner on. Unfortunately, I do not have a new mascara, and also I forgot to put this on under my false lashes, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm not going to put a lot, just enough to blend the falsies together with my real lashes. The next thing we're going to be using is the Ciate Glow 2 Highlighter in Moondust. This is so beautiful. I can't wait to put it on. Also, in my Ipsy bag this month, I got a highlighter brush. Look how cute it is. So we're going to use this to apply this beautiful highlighter. Oh, it's so pretty. Wow, I forgot to dust away that bake. Son of a... I got so much purple on my nose earlier. And I know that you guys can see it. Mmm. This highlighter is so beautiful. We're going to put some right in the center of our forehead with whatever powder is left on this brush just to make it a little bit more subtle. Now we're going to put a little bit of this on the top lip. A little. That's a funny joke. A little bit on the chin. I'll put some more on the nose. Might as well. Why not? I just realized that I forgot to do my eyebrows, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. This is just on my everyday makeup collection. This is a Sugar Arch Arrival Brow Definer. So we're almost done. I'm going to add some finishing touches to my face before we move on to lips. I'm just going to add some more bronzer to make sure that all of the bake is gone so it's not so intense. We're just going to add this all over. I also learned a trick that if you put a little bit a bronzer right under your chin, it makes you look like you have a way fuller palette than you actually do. I'm into that. Now I'm going to use some of this Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray and put it all over my face. So the last thing I have in my Boxycharm is this Smashbox Always On Liquid Lipstick in shade Fair Game. So this is what it looks like. It just looks like a normal nude. So I'm going to put it on and see how it looks. I think it might go well with this look because the eye is like really heavy, but it also might not because the color might not look good on me because sometimes nudes are kind of hit or miss for me. So let's do it. So the lip is okay. I don't think I hate it, but I definitely like am not in love with it. So this is the final look using my August Boxycharm as well as my August Ipsy bag to create this look. I hope that you enjoyed watching this tutorial and that you like this look. I've been really excited to get my hands on that palette because I've needed a really colorful palette that will do me right. So leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think of the eye look. If it's too much, that's okay. I usually do like gold and brown. So stick around. I promise not all my looks are this crazy. And if you are not subscribed already, please remember to subscribe down below and hit that notification bell so that way you do not miss any of my videos. Alrighty, well, thank you so much for being here. I hope that you're having a great day, and I will see you soon.